Hello everyone, in this video I'll show you how to use 8051 microcontroller in multisim and how to relate this key as well as 8051 microcontroller which is placed in multisim tool. The main reason for doing this video is that most of the people do not know how to program 8051 microcontroller in multisim. So for them, if you are aware of coding 8051 microcontroller using Keil, then you can load the hex file which is being generated over there into the 8051 microcontroller which is placed in multisim. So let's begin. I have a multisim tool over here and I'll place a microcontroller 8051 microcontroller using place. Then I'll go for component. In the component, I'm having different options. I'll go for MCU, which is microcontroller unit. Then I'm having 805X series, in that I'll place 8051. So I'll click on OK and I'll place it over here. When I place, MCU wizard will open. There I have to give the workspace path. I can give the workspace path anywhere I want. So I have created a workspace path in a different folder. I've created a multisim folder, then I'll give a path of that, then I have to create a workspace name. And here I'm taking a very simple example of LED blinking using microcontroller. So I'll go for LED blink, then I go for next. Then here in the under the project type, if you are programming 8051 in multisim itself, then you can go for standard, or if you have already done the programming in Keil, then you can always load the hex file into the 8051 microcontroller which you are placing in multisim tool. So if you are loading that, then you can go for external hex file. Then you create a project name LED blink. Then I'll go for next. Then I'll go for create empty project. Then it is finish. So 8051 microcontroller is placed now. You can see the ports, port 1, port 3, port 0 and port 2 along with VCC, ground, XTAL1, XTAL2 for placing the crystal, 11.0592 MHz crystal. Then you are having different options. I'll not touch into that since I'm going for a application based example. So I'll go for the next, placing the power for microcontroller. So again I'll go for placing the power. In that I'll go for power sources. Then I'll go for VCC. For placing power, I have already have VCC, which is a 40th pin of 8051 microcontroller, and ground, so ground over here. Then I need LED, so under the group I'll go for diodes. Inside diodes I'll go for LED. In that LED I'll go for LED red. Okay, so another component which I need is a resistor, so I'll again go for basic. Then resistor, a very small value of resistor I need, that's enough. So I have placed all the components. Now the only remaining part is connecting the components. So VCC I'm connecting over here, then ground, then I've rotated using Control R. Then since I'm connecting it to port 1, I'll give it to port 1, then an LED. Then I'll connect it to ground. I'll change the value of resistors by double clicking this. Then I'll give it as 220 ohm and click OK. Then I'll also change the on current of this LED, because the output current from the microcontroller is very small. So you can always use a transistor at the output side if you're doing the hardware connections. Or I can also give the current over here for simulation purpose. I'll give as 0.1. milliamps of current. Then I'll click OK over here. So you can always code 8051 microcontroller, since I've used an external hex file to be loaded into this. So I'll go back to the Keil software. I've already given an explanation about this in my previous video. You can always click the link given in the description and then you can find out the video on this. So I have this program which is already written over here and which is compiled successfully also. So now if I want to generate an hex file, you have target one which is already present in Keel. So I'll right click on this target one. I'll go for options for target one. In that I'm getting a different options. I have to go for output. In that I have to check create hex file and click OK. Once I click OK, again I have to compile, build it. So when I build it, you'll get something called as creating hex file. So hex file is being created now. So once it is done, let me come back to this multisim. Then I double click this. I'm getting different options such as label, display value, display pins which are available over here, since there are 40 pins all are written over here. Then there is something called as code. So what kind of code it is? MCU code for this component it is being asked. You have to go for properties. In the properties, go for LED blink, which is a workspace name which I have created. Then machine code for simulation. So this is a path wherein I have to load the hex file. I'll go for browse and select the path wherein you have created the hex file. I'll go for ledblink.hex. Then I'll click OK for this. Okay. So then now the hex file is loaded into this. The only job is to run this. So I'll go for run. And you can see that LED keeps on blinking. So there is a lot of delay associated here. So I'll stop here. I'll go back to Keel and I'll reduce the delay because there is a lot of delay associated. So again, I'll say, again, I'll build the target and hex file is being generated. Then simply again need not, load the target file, simply run here. You can see that the delay has been reduced and you can see the blinking of an LED. So likewise, you can always create number of applications using 8051 microcontroller. You can always do hardware connections over here in multisim, and you can do the coding part in Keel and just relate that by loading the hex file over here. Thank you for watching this video. If you like the videos, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.